Welcome back to theCUBE coverage here at KubeCon North America 2025. My name is Paul Nashawaty, and I'm joined today by Sudeep from Traefik. How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Great, great to have you on, and a lot's happening with Traefik. How's the show going for you?
It's going great, Paul.
Yeah, it's super busy, right?
It's day three, but it still seems like day one.
Exactly, exactly. Lots of people, it's still very active for day three, which is pretty crazy. But let's talk about some of your key partnerships, right? That's some of the announcements that happened. We saw some of the activity that's been going around with Nutanix and Oracle. Why don't we expand a little bit on that?
Yeah, and I think, you know, the KubeCon is a great event for us to deepen our partnerships, deepen our kind of relationship with our users. And at this KubeCon event, I was really, you know, pleased to kind of go deeper with two of our partners, Nutanix. You know, we kind of talked about that at theCUBE yesterday.
Yep.
And with Oracle. So with Nutanix, what we did was kind of launch this concept of a unified application intelligence, tying VMs, containers, and serverless together. Traefik provides the layer 7, Nutanix provides the infrastructure and the layer 4. So it's a beautiful partnership there.
That's great.
And with Oracle, we kind of move forward in our partnership, integrating all of the Traefik portfolio into OCI and OKE. So, you know, we're making a lot of progress with them, not just on API, but also with AI. You know, as you know, Oracle is going super hard on kind of the AI, making AI available in multiple different geographies. So, you know, we're pleased to see those partnerships kind of come to fruition.
Yeah, absolutely. So, but can we explain to the audience a little bit about why this is important? Like, why is it really important for this?
Yeah, and I think if you look at, take a step back, look at the trends, what are happening. Hybrid cloud, multi-cloud, on-prem, sovereign cloud deployments are on the rise.
Yeah.
And what customers are looking for is to be able to run their infrastructure wherever they want.
Yeah.
And they want a unified operating model. And that's why this becomes very important, because what Traefik does is operates at the layer 7 at the application layer, and therefore working with infrastructure providers like Nutanix, like Oracle, makes sense because we can make that same architecture available wherever the users want.
Yeah, yeah. Now, actually, absolutely. And when we were walking by your booth and we were talking, there's a lot of Traefik at your booth. Say, no pun intended there, Traefik, right? but there's there was a lot of conversation around operational models, right? And there's also offline models and such. Can you talk a little bit about that? Like, why was that so important to talk about?
Yeah, so there's two parts to that. One is the operating model on how you manage the infrastructure, specifically how do you do day two ops. And increasingly more people are going down the path of infrastructure as code, everything being fully declarative.
Yep.
And Traefik has been fully declarative from day one. So that's a very nice validation of the approach that we took many, many years ago. Second part to that is the deploy anywhere requirement almost that's coming up, where it's not just they don't want to just deploy everything on the public cloud, they don't want to bring everything on-prem, there's going to be this hybrid nature, but also they want sovereign optionality to be able to move and port their application to wherever they want. It could be in a data center that is totally air-gapped, offline, disconnected from the internet, or it could be some combination of all of these options. So people are looking for options because this thing is now entering the next phase, I would say, of optimization. You know, a lot of trials have happened. People have figured out how public cloud works, how private cloud works. Now I think, you know, with cost kind of being the overarching kind of theme, people are really trying to cost, compliance, and risk. If you look at all of that under the umbrella, people want optionality.
Yeah.
They want to have that flexibility, deploy anywhere, same operating model, whether it's a VM, whether it's a serverless, or whether it's a container, like a microservices type workload.
Yeah, freedom of choice absolutely is something that's the kind of key theme of the show as well, is just choice happens, it's really how we're
right.
Dealing with it. But like one of the things that is very apparent, you know, being at KubeCon, we have, of course we're going to have cloud native and Kubernetes kind of focus, but the big theme that I'm hearing is around, of course, AI. AI is a big area of focus.
Right.
MCP gateways and AI API gateways, that's a big kind of conversation. Agents is a big conversation. What does this mean for Traefik?
Yeah, and this was a big topic of conversation at our booth. People are coming to the realization that MCP gateway, API gateway, AI gateway, they cannot be three distinct product offerings, even though they have different scope.
Yeah.
Being mandated to deploy three different products in their architecture is a non-starter.
Right.
So they're looking for ways to bring it all in together, and then that's another validation of what Traefik has already done. You know, with us, we package the API, the AI, and the MCP gateway into a single binary.
Oh, wow.
And that is extremely compelling when you're trying to deploy this at scale.
Yeah.
And we kind of wrote about this, and the concept of a triple gate pattern emerges for agentic workflows. And what that really means is when you're trying to secure an agentic workflow, you have to secure three parts of the conversation. You have to secure the conversation that an agent has with the LLM. You have to secure the conversation that the agent has with the APIs through the MCP server.
Yep.
And then you have to control the conversation and secure the conversation between an agent and the MCP server resources. Okay. These are three distinct protocols, three distinct ways of doing so, but being able to bring them all together in a compelling platform, infrastructure as code, that operating model, and giving people the deploy anywhere capability, all of that is a super compelling value prop, which got validated at our booth this
week. Well, and on top of that, it also sounds like it reduces complexity significantly, right? And that's one of the key areas that we see that
exactly.
is a challenge with AI workloads.
The fragmentation is a real problem. You know, whether you talk about fragmentation between workload types, you know, fragmentation between VMs, containers and serverless, but also fragmentation of the AI ecosystem. You know, whether you're talking about an API gateway, an AI gateway, an MCP gateway, I mean, there's fragmentation already starting to happen and people don't like it,
yeah.
and they're looking for better options.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. So one of the other things that was kind of interesting around your booth was your t-shirts. What's the deal? Everybody wants the t-shirts.
Yeah, I should have worn one, but you know, every year, every time we're at KubeCon, the t-shirts seem to be the biggest hit.
Yeah.
And this year, again, people came to our booth just looking for t-shirts.
Well, I need to get my t-shirt.
I'm going to get your t-shirt,
I
yes.
appreciate it.
Yes.
All right, so big news happened at this event, right? We saw that there's a major shift in the Kubernetes ecosystem today, right? We saw that Kubernetes SIG network officially announced that the retirement of the Nginx environment. So let's talk a little bit about that, because
yeah.
that's a big impact to the ecosystem.
Yeah, that was a... It happened yesterday, you know, we're day three today, so you know, towards the end of day two.
It's just one long day for me.
Oh, I know. a big announcement got dropped, and there's two parts to that announcement, so you know, to parse it properly. Ingress Nginx, which has been kind of a very popular open source Kubernetes Ingress solution, used by many, many users and many, many companies, they announced that they're going to end of life at the end of March 2026. So we have four months.
Yeah, four months.
And there will not be any bug fixes, any enhancements, any support thereafter.
That's aggressive.
Yeah, and that would have been okay if the follow-on project for that would have kept going. And that was the second part of the announcement,
okay.
which is Ingate, which was supposed to be the follow-on project that would carry it along, also declared that they're basically folding shop. And they're done because they could not get enough people to participate in that community and contribute.
Well,
so with both of these coming together at an end, I mean, now customers are really struggling to find an option.
Yeah, well, we see 41% of internet-facing clusters run on Ingress today. Right,
yeah.
run today.
Yeah, it's
so
wild.
So how, what are the options? It sounds like Traefik has a solution, right?
We have a solution, luckily, because we saw this coming a few months back. When Ingress Nginx actually announced that they were going to end of life, they didn't give a date, but they announced that they were going to end of life and Ingate was going to take over. We quickly followed up with that. We created a Ingress Nginx provider to kind of seamlessly migrate users to Traefik with minimal changes to their infrastructure. So we released that back in July of this year.
Okay.
And now with this becoming a forcing function, I think that becomes a great pathway for people to migrate off of Ingress Nginx and go to Traefik.
How seamless or frictionless is it?
It's literally a drop-in replacement.
Okay.
So you you install the Traefik binary, you replace the existing Ingress Nginx binary. Your configuration that you have used in the Ingress Nginx, that stays.
Okay.
So you preserve that configuration, and we're going to do the magic on the back end, being able to convert from the Ingress Nginx over to the Traefik side.
Yeah, it sounds like this is a major move in the ecosystem.
This is a major development.
Yeah.
And if you look at, there's a lot of Kubernetes distros managed Kubernetes distros that use Ingress Nginx under the hood, and you know they will now have to find a second option.
No, that's great. I mean, I think that it's great that you have a solution for this, right? I think it's a little bit challenging when you just say, okay, 41% of internet-facing clusters are using it, yet there's no path forward, right?
Not only do we have a solution, I think the important thing here to also realize is our commitment to open source.
Yep.
You know, we've been doing this for 10 years, and we have not wavered in our commitment to open source. Traefik started back in 2015 was the first project, so 10 years ago. The first code was put in GitHub, and now we have 3.4 billion downloads. We have over 900 contributors. We have almost 59, pushing 60,000 GitHub stars. Didn't happen by accident, right? It was a methodical, committed, very diligent effort in building a community. And so that's what people are going to get that are migrating away from Ingress Nginx. You know, you're not getting another just people that are doing this on part-time basis. There's a real company behind it.
Yeah.
Open source is really important to us. But also we have advanced capabilities. So if and when those users want to choose to migrate or to upgrade, I should say, to advanced capabilities, we provide that pathway. And that's a very seamless pathway. You know, within 30 seconds, you can upgrade your OSS to advanced capabilities with the unlock of a license, and you would have everything.
Yeah, reducing that complexity, adding the frictionless movement, that's really, really great. This is awesome, great news. I mean, great, kind of exciting, too, at the same time.
It is exciting.
It's really exciting.
It's exciting that we have an option to provide to the community.
Right, absolutely, absolutely. So let's fast forward. We're here next year, we're sitting here talking. What are your thoughts? What do you want to see next year at this time with Traefik, with the show, with everything?
Yeah, I think same spirit, deepen our partnership with users, be able to provide value, build more champions, deepen our partnerships with Nutanix, with Oracle. Perhaps there'll be others on the table as well.
Yeah.
We want to do what we love doing, which is solving problems and making it easier for users to kind of just use infrastructure at scale.
Yeah, well, Sudeep, it's always a pleasure having you on and having the conversations. It's forward thinking. I like where you're going with it. I like that the audience can have a place to go and learn about the next generation of where they want to go with their solutions. So thanks for being on.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Great to be here, Paul.
Paul Nashawaty coming to you live from the show floor at KubeCon North America 2025. Coming from theCUBE, your leading source of tech news.